Goldson's cast long shadows, Melinda is hired to do an estate sale, which leads her into a classic haunted house scenario where she goes up against not one, but several ghosts who are haunting this house. Things get kind of violent in the episode with these ghosts at war with each other, and Melinda encounters some pretty evil entities in this house. One of the most challenging things about writing this episode was finding the balance between the various stories, because as you'll see when you watch, Melinda's really peeling back the layers of a very complicated puzzle, and juggling that and the various ghosts in the house, which are from different time periods, I think that was probably one of the biggest challenges. When we finally had the haunted house element of the story all worked out, we realized that we needed to track Melinda's personal life and her friendship with Delia. And in the previous episode, Delia had a brush with death thanks to one of Melinda's ghosts. So we thought it only seemed natural that Delia, who's gone from being a skeptic to a full-on believer, is now realizing with the stories we've been doing this season that the whole ghost hunting thing is starting to get a little dangerous. In fact, we've sent her son Ned to the emergency room twice already this season, so I think the stakes are definitely higher, and she's starting to see that it's not always simple what Melinda does in getting ghosts into the light. In terms of how the ghosts are having an impact on Melinda's personal life, one of the problems that she's facing this season is that Aiden is an empath, which means that he will manifest symptoms or behavior of ghosts who are hanging around. And we have a ghost who died of a neurological illness, and Aiden begins to manifest those symptoms, which would alarm any parent, but of course for Melinda, knowing that there's a ghost involved, it just ups the stakes in terms of getting that ghost into the light as soon as she possibly can. It's really been fun this season to write some of the younger ghosts, and especially to write Aiden, who's a wonderful character, because Aiden can be very funny. He can also be a little disturbing because he has this gift that Melinda and Jim are still trying to figure out. And my background, I started out writing The Wonder Years, which was a show with pretty much a child cast, and so for me it's especially fun to be able to write those younger characters. I don't know if I personally believe in ghosts, but I will say that ever since I was a kid I've been fascinated by ghosts and haunted houses and secret passageways and Ouija boards and crystal balls and fortune telling and a lot of the things that sometimes figure into the storytelling on Ghost Whisperer. So ending up on this show has been a real treat for me to be able to write this kind of material and really have some fun with the spookiness and the haunted house elements. So there you have it. I'm Mark Perry for Ghost Whisperer. Please tune in for Old Sins Cast Long Shadows on Friday night at 8 o'clock on CBS.